Hey, everybody. We're here live at London Bridge Studio in beautiful Shoreline, Washington. My name is Geoff Ott. We also have Eric Lilavois here, manning our beautiful Neve board. And we have a very special performance tonight from a band called A Consecutive Sequence. And I saw these guys play about a month ago at the Good Shepherd, and I was totally blown away. Their musicality, the performance, the passion that they put into their music. I said, I have to have them at London Bridge, and let's do a live thing. So here we go. We're doing it here. We got Dio, and we have Brian. And tell me a little bit about yourself, guys. Like, what were some of your influences in creating this music?
Dio and I both come from pretty different listening backgrounds. As a saxophonist and kind of growing up in the jazz education system, of course, I went through, like, you know, typical saxophone greats, Charlie Parker, John Coltrane, but then started kind of veering off in my own personal interests of kind of late Coltrane, which is a lot more freer, more aggressive, Archie Shepp, which is just like a wildly emotional tenor saxophone player, and so those are some of my saxophone influences, but you know, into this project, I've always been drawn to more aggressive styles of music for whatever reason, and kind of that aesthetic sense of power and aggression. And so that's one thing that I really like to bring into this. And also, one thing you'll notice in our set is that we do a lot of developing sonic textures. It's a very conscious thing that, you know, Dio and I both really love about, like, electronic music. You have something repeat over and over again, and gradual development of sonic texture. And so, you know, that's kind of where I'm coming from. And so I bring those kinds of aspects from a saxophone into the duo.
I definitely hear that sense of kind of electronic with the looping pedals that you're doing and the different sounds, the octavers and everything. You know, I was trying to think of what genre you guys are, and I've just never really heard anything like that. So it's very cool. And how about you, Dio?
For me, coming from a self-academic aspect of jazz for the sake of versatility and playing, just to use it in what I really find to be the most passionate of genres, dance music, really. So it's all the way through. For me, my one focus is, no matter what I'm doing, is it grooving? Is it hitting hard? Am I able to sort of tap my toes and move my feet, even in the sort of esoteric free jazz sections? You usually hear like a disco beat slipped in underneath it. And so,
yeah. One thing that we really try to do is make sure we have like that sense of ground, that foundation in our songs. That's something you can always pull back into. And it does, and as Dio was saying, like, a sense of free, even if it's a sense of like freeness, it still comes back to kind of a centered focal point that you can kind of relate to. And I don't know, maybe try to hum if you can later.
Nice. Excellent. Well, it's definitely very entertaining. And I thank you guys for being here tonight. And without further ado, let's do it.
All right.
Yeah.
Huh? Thank you.
That's all right. Thank you.
be here today at London Bridge Studios, this amazing historic venue that has done a huge amount, not just for Seattle, that's clear, but for the entire world. So thank you again, Geoff, for having us and you guys being here. And the amps. So this next song is dedicated to all the artful people of the world and all the brown people of the world and all the artful brown people of the world and a good friend of ours, Senor Art Brown. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you again.